Our final guest is one of the country's best-loved comics, who shot to fame after creating and appearing in the award-winning radio and television sketch show Goodness Gracious Me, which in turn spawned the classic The Kumars at number 42. He's now treading the boards as King Arthur in the multi-award-winning show Monty Python's Spamalot. And not only is he a comedy genius, but back in 2003 he even had a number one hit with Gareth Gates.
Is it driving distance?
I'm going to need a gun foot ring.
There better not be stairs, whatever it is.
Now shut up, this is my big sitar solo.
Please welcome Sanjeev Bhaskar.
Scary, scary.
Scary. It takes you back, does it?
Don't be scared.
And yet your music career didn't take off.
You know, fate. That's it. Needed the Gareths. But I'm sure he'll make a comeback.
We will. So, which part of your whole career did you ever sit down one day and thought, the big role I want to play is King Arthur?
No, it was Billy Elliot. followed by Maria in The Sound of Music. like my pop career, that's kind of, I don't think that's going to happen. No, I never imagined that I'd ever do a musical, but
Did you sing and dance before? I mean, could you sing to a sort of a decent degree before you got the part? They obviously loved you anyway.
To an absolutely indecent degree,
really.
Yeah, well, I went to the audition and I said, well, you can tell me.
Right.
And I absolutely expected to go in and for them to go, you can't sing, you can't dance, but it was lovely to meet you. to my shock, they kind of said, would you like the job?
So, are you loving it?
Yeah, it's just fantastic. Yeah, I am loving it, actually.
It's supposed to be. I haven't seen it. One of my friends was in it, Hannah Waddingham, I think she played. She was in the original
Lady of the Lake.
And I feel so bad because I still haven't had time to see it, but it is supposed to be. Even you, Carol, might like this. It's supposed to be the funniest
musical. I probably would, actually. Yeah.
Well, I think we should go. Let's come get
Esther
here.
She's not a theatre
fan.
Shall I go out and come back? See, the knuckle dusters you don't need, all right? Just leave those out.
What's been the most challenging part for? Has it been the sort of the musical and the singing and the dancing, or has it, you know, just been taking on a historical role or being in a Monty Python thing? What was the thing that scared you the most?
All of it, actually. Yeah, the fact that it was Monty Python, and I was, a Monty Python fan when I was growing up, and so you're suddenly aware that you're saying these lines that you know so well.
Yeah.
Except there's a whole bunch of people like now just staring at you. That was quite scary, and the singing and the dancing definitely, because I'd never appreciated how important an ensemble is, the chorus. I mean, they're the backbone of every, musical and West End show, but they get the least attention. Yeah. So, lots of attention to them right now because they are amazing. Yeah. And I'm in awe of them still.
Have you had any scary moments on stage? Any?
It's been very hot recently and it gets very hot on stage, and I'm wearing three layers. I'm wearing these rather fetching leggings, and then sort of this woolen chainmail over the top of that and a tabard. And so in the few minutes that I am off, I go back to my dressing room, take the gloves off, which are very thick, and I stick them in the fridge.
Right.
So when I put them on, they're nice and cool.
Yeah.
I forgot them in the fridge. So I went on stage, with basically a third of my costume missing. And everyone off stage was saying, where are your gloves? And I was saying, they're in the fridge. And they're looking at me like, what? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And how do you choose what you want to do then? Because you're multi-talented, aren't you? You write and you act and you sing and you dance. And The Kumars at number 42 was just so brilliant.
When
are you going to bring it back?
I have to say, this is the closest experience that I've had to being a guest on The Kumars.
Oh,
because
yes.
I'm surrounded by four people. Not saying which one of you is the granny.
No, go on.
Yeah, all right. No, I couldn't possibly. Well, all four of you then. You asked for it. You set yourself up. My goodness. In different ways, of course. But it was lovely to do. I'd love to do something with the characters again because I think that it was. I created it as to not be a cynical show. For it to be quite warm and
funny.
Yeah,
but it's,
really.
It's gone to the States as well, isn't it? Didn't they recreate it in the States?
They did, yeah. It went around the world, actually. And in Australia, it was a Greek family. In America, it was an Hispanic family.
Yeah.
It didn't go to a series there, but the Nows were shown there, and we won a couple of awards and things there.
Where did you get your inspiration for that? Was that really like your family?
Well, no, and they're watching, so... I'm legally obliged to say no. No, it was. In fact, many years ago, I took a girl home to meet my parents, and I introduced them, and my father said, lovely to meet you. How much does your father earn? And I said, you can't ask that. And he said, I'm only asking a question. She doesn't have to answer it. And I said, well, you don't have to shout. And my mum stepped in, and I thought, voice of reason. And my mum said...
Yeah, it does.
But they were also sort of around backstage during the making of the show, weren't they? Really was, doing that?
Well, there were a couple of instances that really stood out. Yeah, they kind of said to Minnie Driver, we understand that you haven't got a place in London now, and we're quite near the airport. So if you want to come and stay with us, we do have a Z bed.
Just don't let it fall. What, she jumped at the chance?
My favourite was Helena Bonham Carter. I introduced my mum to Helena Bonham Carter, and my mum said, you're such a pretty girl. And she said, oh, thank you. She said, why in that last film did they put you in a monkey face?
Are they proud of you now, your parents? Because they didn't particularly want you to go on the stage, did they?
As long as the check's clear every week.
Yeah, they are now,
which is lovely.
Yeah.
Well, listen, you're doing so well, and you became a dad, of course, relatively recently.
Yeah, well, I was interested in what you were talking about just now, actually, with the IVF stuff. We didn't have IVF, but, I know a lot of people who have. Yeah. And it is. Parenthood is the most extraordinary thing that's ever happened to me. And I get more joy out of him than anything else, out of our little boy. And they're just so funny.
They are.
As an entertainment, as a piece of entertainment.
Mm-hmm. Pardon? Expensive.
Well, it depends, doesn't it? I mean, you could buy a CD player and MP3 and all the rest of it. Or sure. Have a child. Have a child. Fantastic. Get all in one.
You're not going to convince her, No. But thank you
I'll
so
show you
much.
Some pictures.
Thank you for joining us
after
today.
The dirty
Sanjeev Bhaskar, everybody.
Thank you.